Well, welcome back to the WECK Local Business Spotlight. I am Mark Oham. Next up in the pickle jar, I got a new friend of mine, and he just got in here to the studio, and we probably talked for the last hour and a half. Fascinating stuff. If you're a business owner or looking at buying or selling a business, I think this guy here is going to perk up your ears. You're the expert now, right?
Yes.
And his name is Tony?
Tony DeSimone, yes.
Welcome to the show, Tony. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
So tell me, how does someone become a business consultant?
I could tell you how I did. I started in accounting and actually started with Deloitte, the CPA firm. And I quickly discovered as an auditor that I hated auditing, but I loved the small businesses that I was going into. And I quickly, after I got my CPA, I quickly moved into working in those small businesses as an assistant controller. I wanted to be inside the business.
Right.
I really liked the idea of the cost accounting side of the business and taking the numbers and using those numbers to improve profitability and cash flow. So I quickly moved into a business as an assistant controller and continued to move my way up from assistant controller to CFO, played the role of COO, and then as I got more experienced, even default owner, when the business owners would hire me with businesses that were truly struggling and they just were paralyzed. They didn't know what to do. And so they would bring me in, and I would literally be able to just take the reins and help turn it around, which
wow.
was just exciting for me. I truly enjoyed that. But
then you said, wait, how am I going to make money at doing this?
Well, then, you know, I really enjoyed that. And that was always a pretty good paying job. And what's nice about getting a CPA is that it opens a lot of doors for you.
Oh, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And it's really, it was really helpful to allow me to continue to grow on the path that I was growing. But part of what I did to become a consultant was I inherently liked teaching. So I went to UB about 4 years after I graduated accounting school, and I was just so appreciative of what I got out of UB, which ironically, when I was there, I wanted to get out of UB as quickly as possible.
But wait a second, you went back as a student or as a teacher?
I went back 4 years while I was actually working at Deloitte, and went back to one of my professors and volunteered and said, brought my resume and said, if you ever need an adjunct professor, I would love to teach here.
Oh, wow.
So 6 months later, I got a phone call. And he asked me to come in to just kind of do a trial class in front of him and three of the other professors that I had 4 years prior. And I got the job. And then for 13 years, I was adjunct professor teaching basic accounting at UB.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And so while I was...
You know your numbers.
Yeah. Well, you know, it was fun. It was a lot of fun. I really
Well, a guy like me wouldn't think that was fun, but yeah, I'll take your word for it.
And while I was there, I learned about a branch of UB called the UB Center for Entrepreneurial Leadership. And what that
I've
is...
I've heard of this.
Yeah. So it's a branch of UB that teaches business owners a lot of the areas of business that they're not necessarily familiar with, such as accounting or finance or marketing or, you know, any of the areas that they may be weak
yeah.
in. It's essentially... getting a mini MBA without the credits. You know, that's
yeah.
really what this...
I've had friends of mine that are business owners that have attended.
It's a great, you know, it's been around for over 30 years. And so I heard about that and I was like, wow, those are my people, you know, business owners. Those are the people I want to be around. 'Cause I wanted more experiences with them. And so I went there one day and just like I did at UB, I volunteered to teach there. Or to present there, whatever was available. And fortunately, at the time, I met with the assistant dean, Tom Albrecht, and they didn't have anybody that was teaching just how to read your financial statements and how to use those financial statements to improve profitability and cash flow.
Right, yeah. The accountant doesn't teach you how to read them. They just give them to you.
Yeah.
So nobody really tells you what they mean.
Right.
And I wouldn't know. I'd get a P&L statement, but I didn't know exactly what it meant.
Right.
You know, it meant I'm losing money, but why? You know?
Right. And so your financial statements, the key to the financial statements is not that you can just look at the history. The idea there is that you want to get those financial statements so that you can use them. And if you know how to do this, to use them to forecast your future,
yes.
That's a very powerful tool. And
yes.
So at UB CEL, that's what I was given the opportunity to do. And what I discovered very quickly was because all these years of working in small businesses, I was creating tools, forecasting tools, cash flow tools, you name it. And I was educating the team as to how to read your financials and focusing on KPIs, key performance indicators, and just creating a communication with numbers that it allowed me, when I finally started volunteering at the UB Center of Entrepreneurial Leadership, that there was a lot that I knew that I had that they needed. And so after several years of volunteering, I began to create a side business, basically a side consulting business, helping people,
right,
helping business owners, which then led eventually to full-time consulting business about 4.5 years ago.
Wow, man, that is, and I like how you, oh, by the way, you're listening to the WECK Local Business Spotlight. We're talking to Tony here. He's a business consultant with a company called You're the Expert Now. Tony's number is 912-1982. Again, 912-1982. And Tony just was telling us how he got into business consulting. But I find it really, really fascinating. I wish you would have been around, or I wouldn't have listened anyway. I tell my wife this story, every new little business that I open, I'm closer to that 1 in 10 that makes it. So I'm at 10 now. So this must be the one that's going to make
it. It's got to be the one.
This has got to be the one. Imagine you could forecast the future off of your past numbers. Who would have thunk of that kind of craziness?
Well, you're not alone. There's a lot of business owners that struggled the same way you have, and that's why it's important to have accurate, timely financial information. And it's also important not to cheap out on getting a bookkeeper. Could, if you recognize that if you have timely, accurate financial information and you learn how to read that financial information, you hire the right person, you could forecast your numbers and you could essentially almost see the future.
Yeah, no, then that makes a ton of sense to me. Going back to that course you were talking about at UB, I had friends of mine, business owners and clients that went there. And there's some really interesting things that came out of it. And one good friend of mine, he needed a succession plan for his family because he doesn't want to be the guy the rest of his life. You know, he wants to retire out and move forward with his life and have his family take over. And he found that class very valuable for that because I thought the world of him for having the guts, because we're manly men. We know how to do everything. And we started this business, right? We started it. So we're going to, and we made it successful, and only we know how to run this place. And to admit to ourselves that we need help is difficult.
Yes.
Really difficult.
It is. And I'm glad you brought up succession plan, because that's one of the biggest blind spots that business owners fail to see, that they don't have a succession plan or an exit strategy. And so, think about it. Think if you had been putting all of this time and effort into this business that you built that could maybe have been decades of hard work. And the moment you retire, it ends.
It ends.
And you end up with nothing. That is a scenario that many business owners face. And it's because of the fact that what they have is what's called a lifestyle business. It will die with you. When you die, it dies.
Yes.
And all of that hard work, all those decades of hard work, you end up with nothing. Just imagine if you had a 401k and you were putting, you know, tens of thousands of dollars in it year after year after year, and the moment you retire, it goes to zero. That's essentially what's happening.
Well, in, you know, as a business owner myself, and talking to you for the last hour and a half or whatever we were, you know, I feel totally comfortable with if I, you know, would hire you, you'd be my guy.
Oh, thank you.
I like to think I'm the hard-headed, you know, typical guy that owns a business, and I know how to do things, and good for you, man. You got a way around this thing. So once they hire you or sign you on, you know, how does it work from there? I know you were talking about working in the business for a little while.
Yeah, I like to get a little bit immersive in the business because I like to get to know the people involved in who's running, you know, the business. Because what I discover is that when they bring me in, let's say they bring me in because they have cash flow problems. Cash flow is never the problem. That's the symptom. The problem happened way upstream. And all these problems eventually led to cash flow issues.
Right.
And so what I like to do is I like to get in there, get to know the executive staff, get to know how the company is run, understand the culture, and then learn what are the real reasons why this is happening, why they're struggling. Mm-hmm. And what I have discovered and what I continue to get better at is I recognize that there's these taboo topics that the business owners and the partners and the executive staff don't ever want to talk about because it creates arguments.
Sure.
And are the reasons why you have the cash flow.
It's worse than a bad marriage, because in a marriage you can get divorced.
Yes.
In a business you can't.
Yes. Yes.
So you have to live with each other.
Yes. Yeah. So then what I do is because I'm an outsider and it's not emotional for me, it's not personal, it's not, you know, I'm not trying to do anything political to gain something. I get all the people in the room that need to be in the room to deal with whatever that taboo topic is so that we could talk it through, we could clear it up, and then we can start working on the business.
Yeah, but you're a psychologist.
To a certain degree, it feels like it at times.
And a marriage counselor.
At times, yes.
And a business consultant all rolled into one.
Yes.
And a CPA, no doubt.
And it's fun. I really enjoy it because it gives me an opportunity to go into all these different businesses, all these different industries, and experience something different all the time.
I love your passion. I can see it bleeding through
you
when we were talking that, you know, I think this doing this show is the highlight of my week, these different interviews with different clients, because I get to meet so many people like you. And what makes you tick? And, you know, why did you go into the shoe business? You know, what got you there? And why do you stay there? You know, it's just so interesting. And then you're the guy that's consulting with all these businesses.
Yeah.
Well, we better give this is a WECK local business spotlight. I'm your host, Mark Owen. The name of the company is You're the Expert Now. We're talking to Tony over here, and he is the president of the company. His number is 912-1982, 912-1982, and his official title is a business consultant, but it sounds to me like he's a divorce attorney, CPA. Wears a lot of hats when he comes into your business. So if somebody wants to hire you on, where do they start? They just call you and say, listen, I got a sick business.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, if they're struggling in any way with their business, they just give me a call.
Just financially though.
No, not. I do a lot of coaching and just helping with issues that, like I said, the taboo topics, issues that people don't want to talk about, and they feel like I can't resolve this myself.
Wow. So, and what about like the big picture stuff too? I mean, should we grow? Should we stay small?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm fat and happy. Everybody's making money. But if I take on one more contract or one more piece of business, it's going to blow me up. You know, where do I go from here? Then you plan that out for them and build a map?
Yeah, so with my numbers background, I always include numbers in helping the business owner make the decisions that they eventually make. But I also bring in other things like strategic direction, exercises, and things like that, so that we can also think bigger picture. Because one of the first questions I ask, regardless of the issues, is what is your exit strategy? What is your succession plan? Because if I don't know where you're headed, as they say, any road will do. And some of those roads are very expensive.
I'm curious. Yeah, they are expensive. I'm curious when you said that about the exit strategy. Are you surprised how many people don't have one?
Very. Not anymore, I guess. because most don't. And as I was saying to you before, what happens is that the majority of them never sell. So they die with the owner. And that does not have to happen. All you have to do is just write down an exit strategy, just some of your ideas of what you think you might. And that alone will get you started with moving forward. But the only way to really get to an effective exit strategy is to have an effective emergency plan. And what I mean by that is a lot of business owners can't leave their business for more than a week. And some can't even leave their business.
What are you talking about? Some, I know some that can't leave it for a minute.
Exactly. Now that's a true sign of a lifestyle business. What an effective emergency plan is to eventually create a business where you can leave for 3 months and it can run without you.
That's
an effective emergency plan. What that means, if you can do that, is that you have a team behind you that is extremely capable of running the business without your help, which then means you have what's called legacy equity. You have equity in your business, and you now have something that you can sell when you're ready to retire.
Wow. And you just gave away hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars worth of free advice.
I'm happy to do it. There's
for our WECK listeners, I'm telling them, you got a nice earful there.
I'm happy to do it.
And you're a good man, Tony. I appreciate you coming in, man.
My name's Anthony DeSimone, or you can call me Tony. You're the Expert Now, LLC. And my phone number is 716-912-1982. And I'd be more than happy to talk to you about any struggles you might be having with your business.
That is fantastic. And this is the WECK Local Business Spotlight.
Thanks for listening to the WECK Local Business Spotlight. Listen every Saturday morning from 11 until noon for businesses and services that are born right here in Buffalo. If you would like a business featured, call or email WECK.